I'm Deep Mahaman and you're watching The Redman TV.
Fucking hell. Liverpool 2, Ludogorets 1. 4 heart attacks later and we got through it. Jesus wept. After one of the, well, arguably the second worst first half performance of the season. Pish poor, we continued exactly where we left off against Aston Villa. But second half, Brendan Rodgers made the substitutions. And I think to a man, every Liverpool fan watching that game went, Lucas and Barini. Didn't make a great deal of sense at the time, but you know, change the formation, change the system. And you know what? I'm going to give fucking loads of credit to Fabio Barini. You know what? The fellas around me were like, he's fucking garbage, him, when he came on the pitch. He's garbage, he's shite, what does he fucking bring? Well, you know what? For me, I don't go as far as to say he changed the game completely, but you know what? He added an element to the game that we didn't have before that. He created the first decent chance, had a good header saved by the keeper, put a flick on for Mario Balotelli as well, ran around, won free kicks, got stuck in, made a nuisance of himself. Was a proper centre forward, and I thought he did a decent job there. So, you know, Jordy's still out, needs to score goals, of course. Like, but you know what? If he can come in and do things like that, then maybe he's got a place at Liverpool long term. Lucas wasn't, like, you know, we put him on in a more advanced role. But again, you know what he showed? His ability to just win the ball back. He's when he needs to be a fucking defensive midfielder, he does the defensive midfielder's job. And I thought that just helped us have a bit of a more solid base to a certain extent. That being said, though, when we got the goal, no, Mario Balotelli gets it. Wasn't thrilled with his performance all around. But again, if he gets in the box and he scores goals, he's going to make himself a Liverpool legend, isn't he? Just phenomenal. I thought the atmosphere for the first 20 minutes, half an hour, was absolutely electric at Anfield. And if Faden, we knew it wouldn't. It was frustrating. I want to see Liverpool be far more attacking, far more assertive. I thought we should have started with two up front, but we never. And you know what? He made the change, and ultimately we got the 3 points. And it means, not pressure off, but the pressure really, really would have been on if we'd not come away with something from there. And the fact that, you know, it goes back to 1-1, and so many people went, fuck that, I'm off, and got off. But, you know, we stuck it out. Mankio, I thought, had a fantastic game. He gets in there, don't know what their keeper was doing, gets the pen, Steven Gerrard, no one else you'd want in that situation, steps up, fucking bangs it in. There's the first 3 points on the board in Liverpool's Champions League return. Anyway, let me know your thoughts. Who was your man of the match for Liverpool today? It's a struggle. I'm going to give it to Mankio. Mankio, a bit of a fucking shout from fucking left field there, or right back. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget, we're going to be analysing this game in far greater detail once I've fucking got over my heart attacks on the redmentv.com. It's free for the month. Check it out. Film that tomorrow morning. Don't forget to give the video a like, and don't forget to click the subscribe button as well. Anyway, I'm Paul Machin, outside Anfield, going for a sleep.
Henderson is to be Liverpool's new vice-captain. Obviously, Daniel Agger left the club in the transfer window.